Welcome to the Just KNIME It Recap. If you haven't heard of Just KNIME It before, we provide a weekly data science problem and challenge you to solve it with a KNIME workflow. In the recap, I'll give some of my thoughts on the problem and highlight a few of the solutions from the KNIME Forum. Now, last week's problem was on stocks and forecasting. When I think about these things, I think about the efficient market hypothesis. This basically states that a stock's current price reflects all of the available information. And if you could forecast it to gain new information, it would be reflected in the stock price. Now, we don't live in a fully efficient market, so maybe it doesn't apply, but let me know what you think in the comments. Anyway, on to the challenge. So, you work in finance, and one of your clients wants to understand the value of different company stocks over time. Given a data set of stock prices, you decide to use simple moving averages to tackle this task. What companies have an upward trend for the most recent data, and what companies have a downward trend? So the first solution that I want to highlight is from a user named JM1950SJR. Now they provide three separate dashboards in their workflow, but the one that I think is really interesting is this middle one. Here they use the widgets to control the dashboard as you would most of the time, but they do something interesting here, and they use these widgets to control a Python script. This lets them build a very customizable view, but still have the control from the KNIME workflow. In this case, a candlestick plot. Have you used Python like this before? I think it's really cool. Second solution I want to highlight is from Bertie093. Now, this user does a pretty standard moving average analysis of the stock data, but they put it inside of a group loop. And this is really cool because it allows them to apply this analysis not just to one stock, but to all of them. When we look at their dashboard at the end, it incorporates analysis of every stock right off the bat in the short term, mid term, and long term. The final solution I want to highlight is from Tofusa. Now, Tofusa's addition to the challenge is really kind of interesting. They window their data just like everyone else, but instead of just looking at upward trend versus stagnation versus downward trend, they provide the coefficient from their linear regression directly in the dashboard. This gives us a numeric representation of how strong the upward trend is or how strong the downward trend is. And that's really great if we want to do any downstream analysis on these trends. Follow us on all the usual socials and use the hashtag JustKNIME It to share your solutions with us. Next week's challenge will have something to do with CO2 emissions. So come back on Wednesday to find out. I'll see you next week.